Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokémon Platinum Wedlocke. We're gonna just do a little bit of this episode and then I'm gonna do training, but before I do my training, I have made an executive decision regarding my team and the two Bidoofs I currently have. I'm going to kill off one of them right now. Now, some of you think that's actually absolutely cruel, but I'm sorry, they are unusable. They are completely unusable right now. Completely and utterly unusable. They're just interchangeable. I have to switch between two frickin' Bidoofs paired together. I'm sorry, that's unusable. Some might argue, sure, you can use it if you trained it up and stuff, but this literally the same Pokemon. They have the exact same strengths and weaknesses. So I feel like if we run into one thing that's good against Bibarel, it would kill both of them instantly. I don't know. So I gotta pick one. I've thought about it. Basically, we've got Horay, who is impish and unaware. Psyche is jolly and simple. And Horay already has Rock Smash, an HM. I'm going with Psyche. Psyche is the one I'm keeping. So Horay, unfortunately, I am going to sacrifice you to the gods. So we have made a sacrifice. The gods have thanked us for their sacrifice, and they are granting us to bring a new party member in to be the new partner for Psyche. I'm going with Minyas. Here's what I plan to do for Gardenia. I'm gonna train up these two, Psyche and Minyas. Psyche's not gonna have any play in the battle. I gotta tell you that right now, unless I want to sacrifice her. Basically, Minyas double resists grass. It'd be great. And he'll be Golbat at literally level 22. Unfortunately, he can't get Crobat because I'm pretty sure even if you're max happiness, you do not evolve from Zubat to Golbat and then immediately into Crobat. I think you have to grow at least one more level for it to trigger the evolution to Crobat. I could be wrong, but regardless, we're going to get at least to Golbat. And that's what I want to use against Gardenia. And then for backup will be Psyche, and if Psyche doesn't even matter, doesn't even do it, then I'm assuming Helios will be able to finish off what Minyas could not. So that's the plan, and I just realized now we have every pairing possible. A male, female, two males, two females. But regardless, I'm gonna do training now, and I will see you when I'm done. Hello, everybody, and welcome back after God knows how long it's been. Anyway, in case you couldn't tell, that first bit of this episode was recorded soon after I recorded the one before it, but then there was about a month and a half break, and I'll just briefly explain it, because I went into it slightly in my live streams as to why, but long story short, we moved, and in between the time of us living in our old house and new house, we were living with my in-laws, and it wasn't the worst thing in the world, but I didn't honestly feel comfortable recording there or doing anything of that sort, so I just didn't. So, but anyway, we're back. We have a new house. I have a new office space to record stuff, and we are good to go. I probably should explain the training I did, didn't I? Shouldn't I? I mean, everyone's 22, except Helios is 21. That's because Helios is going to get us through the entire gym, except for Gardenia. And I gave him one level leeway, because he's 22 is the level limit for Gardenia. So basically, once we get to the gym with Helios, we're actually not going to use the pair of Helios and Poseidon for Gardenia. We're going to use Minyas. My logic is, if Gardenia is somehow strong enough to kill my person that is good against her, I'd rather lose Psyche than Poseidon. That was my logic, honestly. And Minyas double resists grass, as opposed to Helios just single resists it. So, that's my logic. Hopefully it works. Hi, I'm Gardenia. I'm the town's gym leader. My last trainer was an awfully speedy young guy. Actually, his name was Barry. If you knew his name, but I'd call him the speedy, I don't know, guy who has his crap together in this game. Like I explained earlier in the playthrough, he's in a hurry. I'm in a hurry too, because Platinum is a slow game. So, alright, are you the first trainer? Oh, I guess I have to talk to you to battle. I forgot about that. Alright, well, we're in a grass gym. And I'm using the god of the sun, or whatever the heck Helios is. I forgot at this point. Oh! This reminds me! I should go in the PC after this and show you guys. Oh, battle animations are still off from my training. Well, it wouldn't be Knockable 11 playthrough without that happening at least once. At least once. It's gonna happen like 5 more times, I guarantee it. It probably already happened once already in the, earlier in the playthrough, but honestly, I can't remember because that was so long ago. So, yeah, I made it to Caroline. Wow, I actually, okay, I mean, I can get to 22 and still battle. It's just if I hit 23, Helios can't participate in the battle with Gardenia. But honestly, that's not a huge deal because I'm counting on Minyas to do it, not Helios. And woohoo, the floral clock. We get to watch time go by, basically. What a fun activity. Alright, yeah, in the PC, I've got Pokémon that I got obtained. I won't say who they are, but, they were... Hold on, battle style. Yeah, set. Battle style... Not on... What am I doing? Why did I go in here? Ah! Okay, wow. Wouldn't that have been funny if I accidentally put it on battle style set? That would have been funny! Except I'm only gonna use one Pokemon in this gym anyway, so it honestly wouldn't have made a difference. It's just funny that I almost clicked that. So yeah, we got two new Pokemon. I guess I could just say who they are. What's the big deal? It's Shieldon and Cherubi. Shieldon was from the fossil, who I named Aegis. The Aegis was a shield used by, I think, Athena? Possibly Zeus as well? So it was not, it wasn't named after an actual character in Greek mythology, but a object. Like I said, I could stretch the, and it makes sense, because, and that's how it's pronounced, by the way. It's not Aegis, or Aegis, it's Aegis. Trust me on this. I know some people probably still think it's wrong, but trust me, that's how you pronounce it. A-E-G-I-S. Like Aegis Slash. But then, the other Pokemon was Cherubi. I caught Cherubi. I forgot what I named Cherubi. Oh, Demeter. Named her Demeter after the goddess of harvest. I caught her in the floral meadow from the honey tree. And I apologize for not showing those on screen. Although, or was he just shown on screen? I don't even remember. But I couldn't because I wasn't doing recording and... I forgot about the honey tree like 5 times. Like seriously, they do not give you much leeway for getting honey tree Pokemon. You have to put the honey on, and then you have to come back within a very specific allotted time. And if you don't, it just goes away, and you have to put more honey. I missed it like 5 times before I actually got a Pokemon, and the first one was Cherubi. So, I'm really glad it was Cherubi and not like male Combi or something, because that would have sucked. Yay, the water level dropped, woohoo. We can now go back if we want, but I don't want to go back, I want to go forward. Forward march. Hopefully Helios doesn't grow a level, I don't think he will. Fairly certain he won't, because we're only gonna fight one Pokemon. Angela! Her name is Angela, wow. That doesn't look anything like my wife, but all right.
I guess there's more than one person in the world named Angela, I just didn't realize that.
And we've burned yet another flower of this gym. We're about to burn some more. Or no, we're gonna slap them with wings. Your ability to conceal your abundant skill. Time flows. Oh, go on, don't be afraid. I am very afraid! Because Gardenia is tough. Do not underestimate Gardenia, because her Roserade, you might not think it's that bad. You know, a grass Pokemon, they have lots of weaknesses. You should be able to counter them pretty easily. But, Roserade, I think I've said this before earlier in the playthrough. Roserade is a fully evolved Pokemon. That is not something you normally see this early in the game. Its stats are a lot higher than than perceived. Like, she also has a Turtwig and a Cherim. Yeah, Cherim, I believe, not Cherubi. Oh, also, Minyas is holding a Soothe Bell, so we can evolve the Crobat sooner than later. Hopefully he actually does. I ran around in circles a while before I walked in here, so maybe he'll grow a level and evolve the Crobat. I don't know. I don't think, someone can correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure, even if you're at max happiness as Zubat, you do not evolve into Golbat and then Crobat in the same level. You at least have to get a 22 to evolve the Crobat, And then 23 is the minimum level to be for Crobat. Golbat, then Crobat. You know what I meant. Wing attack! Slap! And... oh! That's alright. That's not alright! That's not alright, actually. You know what'd be really cool, Gardenia? If you healed. Wow, you healed. Cool. I'm gonna stall the Reflect. I'm going to stall the Reflect because I don't want it to be active on her stronger Pokemon. Turtwig is not a threat in the slightest. Look at this. All it's got is Razor Leaf. It's also got Sunny Day, which just makes Cherim stronger, basically. That's really it. Flinch, haha! And the Reflect should be gone after this turn. Sunny Day. Oh, crap. Well, Cherim's going to be stronger now. That's all it really does. They don't have Solar Beam on their Pokemon. Because if they... Solar Beam on a Roserade this early in the game. That would be OP, in my opinion. But we're fine. Goodbye, Turtwig. Goodbye. And up next is probably... I wonder if she'll send Roserade next. No, about to send Cherim. Okay. Nope, keep battling. Alright, Cherim. Yeah, Cherim's going to change to its flowery form because it's sunny. Yay, happy Cherim!
I don't want to see you happy, Cherim. I want to see you dead.
I wonder if I just try confusing Roserade or if I should just go straight for Wing Attack.
Leech Seed!
That's actually really bad. That's actually really bad. Because I think Roserade has pretty decent defense. Let's say Wing Attack does just a little over half. The Leech Seed will, you know, make it so HP's more than that. I'll hit it again. She'll heal. So, I'm gonna try something. I don't want to be seeded. We're gonna go to Psych. And then I'm gonna switch back immediately. I'm gonna assume she's gonna go for Magical Leaf because it's super effective on Psych. That would be great if she just went for Magical Leaf. Instead of... whatever else she might have. I don't think she... I think she only has grass and poison attacks, so... honestly, no matter what she decides to use, it'll be alright. I think. Oh! Ooh! No! Stun Spore! That's really lucky that missed! But no, we're actually just gonna go for Wing Attack. Because... that did more than I thought it would. Either Cherim's more bulky than Roserade, or... the sunny form is more defensive than its regular form. I thought the sunny form was just plus special attack, not plus defenses too. But maybe I'm not that familiar with Cherim. Grass Knot, really? Grass Knot is does Grass Knot do more damage than Magical Leaf on me? I didn't think Golbat was very heavy, but I don't know. Game, I'm just gonna let you do your thing. I'm gonna pretend this isn't happening because I know for a fact we're not gonna die. Cause that would be really, really stupid. Really, really stupid. And I know this game wouldn't do something like that to me. That just if I had died from just being paralyzed, that would have been really, really dumb. And thank you, game, for not doing that, and we didn't grow a level, so I'll never know if I have max happiness yet. That's alright. But yeah, we got the forest badge that is two badges down. And, I think we're doing alright so far. Cause, Gardenia killed off, Chiquita, my starter, in my other Platinum playthrough. To be fair, I didn't level high enough. I think I was only, like, level 19. So, that's mistake number one that I made, but... but yeah, I think we did a solid battle right there. That was pretty good. Alright, so, I'm gonna meet at the Pokemon Center. I'm gonna heal, and I'm gonna show you the Pokemon I talked about. Alright guys, we're back. Here we are at the PC. We have Aegis the Shield on. He's naughty. So that's really not great. but then it's, yeah. It could be worse, but could be definitely better. And then we got Demeter the Cherubi, who's hasty. And yeah, this is what we got. So. Yeah. There you have it, folks. That's our backup team members. So there's a route to the east of us. Did I ever catch a Pokemon there? I legitimately don't remember. I guess I can see what route it is. What route number is it? It is route 211. Well, I know none of these Pokemon were caught here. I know actually where all of these were caught. Arbor Gate, Route 202, 205, LA Windworks, 201, 207. No, I have absolutely not caught something here. We can use Minius. Why not? He can use Leech Life to not do very much damage to things. There's a trainer. Or we can just fight this, this little ninja boy here. That would be fine. Ninja boy Zach with a Zubat. Well, I have a Golbat, and... insert repeated rant here about how trainers out of routes have way lower level than the Pokemon of the gym leaders that we fight before them. And again, the reason is because we could have gone here before the gym, so they didn't want to make it harder than the gym because it wouldn't make any sense if you had done this first. So, things and reasons and stuff. And yeah, level 23 for Minius.
Will you be a Crobat? Will you be a Crobat? That is the question. But we don't really care because we're just going to Psych right now.
One level, we got to keep the things equal. And Psych is the Beaverel! I don't know if she's good, but she's here. She's on the team. Here's the moves. We got a Headbutt. Headbutt's pretty decent. And we're fighting freaking Zubats that are 8 levels lower than us, so... honestly, if we had a problem, I'd be very, very worried. Ha! Ha! One level! Only one level as a Golbat! Nice job, Minius. I am proud. I am very proud. You are doing Aurora proud right now. Hopefully you can live up to Aurora the entirety of the playthrough, but... I would not be surprised if you did, because... Crobats have never failed me. Or have they? I don't think they have. I'm gonna go with they've never failed me. Unless you count... oh, this is my first encounter! What is it? It is a... Bronzor! Hmm. I like this, you know why? Because normally in a wedlock challenge, you have to use specific genders. Well, Bronzor doesn't have a gender. And since this is my version of a wedlock, where I just use whatever the heck I want, I can use it. And I fully plan to, because Bronzor is a great Pokemon. It's annoying as heck in this game. So having one at my disposal will be very nice. I'm just wondering what move I should use. Headbutt's not very effective, but it gets stab damage. Let's use Rock Smash. I think that's my best bet. And it did like nothing. Good. Good, I'm glad it did like nothing. And Confuse Ray. I don't really like that, Bronzor, but as you can clearly see, it is proving my point as to how these things are super annoying to fight. So it is my turn to be super annoying to the enemy! Imprison. That doesn't prevent you from leaving. No, that just makes us you can't use the same moves as... see, Hypnosis and Confuse Ray. These things are annoying as all heck. And good job, Psych, you're putting up a good fight. Sorta. One more Rock Smash and we should be good. Stamina Confusion, yay! Alright, one more, that should be good. It's gonna have to do, because you're asleep now! So, yeah, throw balls. Throw the balls. We have 10 Pokeballs, these should work. I think Bronzor has a decent low catch rate, so it might take a couple. Either I'm wrong or I was just lucky. Yay, we got a Bronzor! Oh, yeah, I am really excited to use this thing, eventually. I will get to it, like, I feel like I want to... I feel like it's a priority. If someone dies, I want to add this to my team. Because I've always wanted to use a Bronzong in a playthrough. Anyway! Names. Hold on. Alright, folks, this is Achilles! He was the hero character. I'm pretty sure everyone knows who he is. Who is at least somewhat familiar with Greek mythology. Anyway, hopefully no one finds the Achilles heel of Achilles and is able to defeat him. Spoiler, his Achilles heel is either fire and fire or ground, depending on his ability. So, because technically Bronzor only has one weakness. He either... right? Yeah. Yeah. Because, yeah. Yeah. Steel still resists Ghost and Dark in this generation. Oh my god! But yeah, he's either got Levitate or Heat Proof. Heat Proof makes it so he's no longer weak to fire attacks, so it's just regular effective, and Levitate completely avoids ground attacks. And those are two weaknesses. So whichever ability he has, his Achilles heel is the opposite. So I just want to go check on him real quick because I'd like to use him. And I'm probably going to be referring to him as a him because even though he's gender neutral or genderless, careful nature, that's okay. That's okay. It's not amazing. But all right, he's got a levitate. So nice. So his Achilles heel is fire. So if I can pair him with a Poseidon, that'd be really cool. Or a different water type, like Phoebe. Anyway, I'm gonna heal. I'll be right back on the other route. All right, we're back on route 211. I don't know why we're going this way, because I actually don't think we need to go this way. So other than to get our encounter right there, there's really no point in going this way. So yeah, sorry, we're just wasting time, basically. We're gonna get that item down there. I know for an absolute fact that item is important. Watch and see. It will be extremely useful, and I will totally say afterwards, this was worth the trip. This is totally worth all the effort of fighting these trainers and whatnot. I guarantee you I will say that. Anyway, after this, what we have to do is go into the Galactic Building, I believe. Although, yeah, because we can use Cut now. Which reminds me, I have to teach Cut to someone. Yay! I'll probably have to teach it to Psych. Because I know Psych can learn Cut. And, it's, Bibarel. Bibarel is meant to be an HM slave. They literally put it in the game thinking, let's create a Pokemon that could learn as many HMs as possible. Which is not a bad thing, but when you find millions of them like me, you tend to not like them. That's all. Alright, and then you. I believe you're a bird keeper. Look at these beautiful wings! Look at it! Look at it! I want all of you to look at it! Yeah. We got a Starly here. That reminds me of Hermes. It's alright. It's fine! We can go without him! And yay, wow, that nice job, Psyche. You one-shotted it. Granted, it was, you know, a Starly, 5 levels lower than you. Hoot! Hoot! Hoot hoot! Or Hothoot, if you want to pronounce it like how letters are supposed to be pronounced together. Hothoot. Hothoot, because, you know, TH together. It makes a th noise. Hothoot. Vocabulary and Learning 101. T and H together make a th noise. I'm glad you are all here today to learn these things you didn't know before. Hyperfang, 80 base power with 90 accuracy. Headbutt is 70 base power with 100 accuracy. Let's get rid of Growl. I think we're at the point in the game where I don't know if Growl's gonna have much use anymore. I think. But why would I need Hyperfang and Headbutt? Hyperfang is strong, guys, but I mean, I like to be able, being able to flinch. Oh, Hyperfang can flinch. Oh. But it has 90 accuracy. Tempting. I'm gonna stick with Headbutt, though. Sorry. Maybe I'll regret that later, but I'm gonna go with this. And I just realized I'm gonna have to teach her cut anyway. So I think I'm gonna lose Growl anyway. Taunt! That was totally worth the trip. I'm so glad I did that, guys. I'm so glad I did that. Wow. Is there anything in Mount Coronet right now? I think it's literally dead. Oh, actually, no. It's not a dead end. Have we been in Mount Coronet yet? Guys, I don't remember. I really should have paid attention. Guys, I don't think we've been in Mount Coronet yet. We were in Orberg. No, so this is our first time in Mount Coronet, isn't it? See, Mount Coronet has a million different entrances, and all of them have varying different Pokemon. Yeah, we can't go anywhere in here, but, well, never mind. I guess we get our Mount Coronet encounter. It is Chingling. Chingling. All right, well. Chimecho's really bad, guys. I know, because I used one. I told you guys earlier about my playthroughs I've done of Platinum. One was the duo type I tried on streams. My two types were Steel Psychic. Yeah, I ended up getting a Chingling in Encore because it was my only encounter here, I believe. Or I could have also gotten Bronzor, didn't I? Oh no! I got Chingling outside in 211, I got Bronzor in here. Or was it vice versa? It could have been vice versa because I just did that exact thing in this run. But yeah. And a Chimecho sucked. Wow, and that ball sucked. What the heck? Why'd you suck, ball? Why'd you suck balls? Like, seriously, did this Chingling have a low catch rate or something? It must, because... Or I just got unlucky. I think I just got unlucky. Yeah. That's all it was. I just got unlucky. Alright, yay! We got Chingling! I guess yay. I'm willing to give Chimecho a chance. But I've already given him one, and he sucked. Utterly. Name. This is Doris. The character in Greek mythology called Doris has absolutely nothing to do with anything relating to what Chimecho is. But I thought it sounded hilarious because it's just a regular name. I will never use it when I'm trying to think of a serious name for something. So that's why I went with Doris. But anyway, I think this episode's getting long already, which is weird because I feel like we haven't done anything. But oh, we did fight Gardenia. That's kind of important, isn't it? In the next episode, we're gonna cut down these trees, go in the Galactic Building, die a little, then, we're gonna get a bicycle, go down the bicycle road, die a little more, and then... stuff. See you then! Hope you enjoyed, and sorry again for the wait for this episode, but like I said, I didn't feel like recording in my in-law's house, and hopefully you understand. We're gonna go. We're gonna go now. Things will resume. On schedule. Assuming, unless they don't. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and rock on.